Well, good morning, everyone. How are you doing? We are here for day 6 of VBS, so I'm so excited to see all of you here to come to VBS today. So thank you so much for being here. All right, boys and girls, we're going to go ahead and get started here in just a minute. So as you can tell, this is not a normal church service. We don't typically have wormholes and things in church services. Sometimes, but not normally. But as you know, this last week we've been doing Vacation Bible School. It's the stellar VBS theme, and we've had a lot of fun with that. So grown-ups, if you're here with your kids today, thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to spend this week with them. They have been absolutely wonderful. As we go through our time of worship here today, we are going to go through many of the normal elements, but one of the things that we're doing a little differently is any giving that you have today, rather than passing the plates or anything, we have the box in the back. You can go ahead and give there. If it's your first time here today, there's a connection card in the pew in front of you. We would love to get a chance to have a record of your visit and get to know who you are and give you a chance to get to know a little bit more about us. So if you have that handy, if you would just go ahead and fill that out as completely as you can, and you can just drop that in and let that be your gift today. We would love to have that. So one of the things that we're going to do is we're going to kind of open things up the way we have been doing every day with VBS. And one of the things that we always start off with is our pledges. So I have some helpers that are come up and help me with my pledges every day. We had members from each of the teams that were on their best behavior come forward, and they were going to help. And we have three pledges that we do each and every time. So we have our pledge to the American flag, we have a pledge to the Christian flag, and a pledge to the Bible. So when we do our pledges, there are three important parts. First off, everyone on your feet. Very good. All right. And the three parts to our pledges, we're going to begin right here with the American flag. Go ahead and lift that up nice and high. There you go. On screen. Thank you very much. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right. Then we're moving right over here to the Christian flag. Go ahead and raise it up nice and high. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one fellowship uniting all Christians in service and in love. All right, and now nice and high, as high as you can get it. There we go. Last but definitely not least, a pledge to the Bible. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet, a light unto my path, and will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God. All right. Excellent job, everyone. Thank you so much for our helpers. Can we have a round of applause for our helpers? They have always done such a wonderful job with that. And you did a good job, too. Good job, grown-ups. You're so good at this. This week we learned a bunch of different Bible verses, but the main verse that we sort of went through the week with is right up here. Let's read this all together. Jesus said, I am the light of the world, John 8:12. There was a very, very strong light theme throughout the entirety of this VBS, and so we're going to talk a little bit more about that in just a bit here. I want to invite Miss Melinda to come up here. She's going to talk about our mission that we raise for. Every year we have a special mission that we collect things for. Last year we brought in cans for the food bank and so on and so forth. And this year we supported a ministry that we've done every year. And I'm going to go ahead and let Melinda tell you a little bit about that.
Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for being here today. So this year we raised items for Operation Christmas Child that is run by Samaritan's Purse. This is a ministry that sends shoe boxes full of toys to children across the world. It was started by the Grahams, Billy Graham and Franklin Graham, and they are collecting shoe boxes every year. I think they've actually hit 200 million shoe boxes this year. So they have been doing this for quite some time and given out a lot of presents, but also the greatest gift, which is the gospel, the good news of Jesus Christ. Every child that receives a shoebox, they also receive help in, their family receives help financially and education, and also sharing the good news of Jesus, and salvation has awesome from this ministry. So it's a great opportunity for these kids. They wound up just by looking at what they brought in, and you'll get to see some footage of this, of them donating. I think that we have a good start as a church. I think they have brought items in to make about 25 boxes. So give them a round of applause for the great work they did. So generous. So at this time, I'd like to get your attention.
When that shoebox is open, they're overjoyed.
You can see them shouting, jumping.
Oh, look at how much they are excited. This is the first time those children are receiving the shoeboxes. They are so happy.
Every box is important because every box is an opportunity to tell a child about God's love, about his son, Jesus Christ.
If you get the heart of the child, you will reach the heart of the parents, you will reach the heart of the family, and then you will touch the community. That gift box is the beginning into their hearts.
Isn't it incredible how these gifts touch the lives of these children? Every year we see tens of thousands of children discipled, and we couldn't do this without you, so thank you for packing the boxes, thank you for praying for these children around the world. God bless you, and keep packing those boxes.
Amen. So yeah, the shoebox ministry, we've seen that grow each and every year, and to have a good head start, 25 boxes, phenomenal work, kid. Thank you so much, and thank you, grown-ups, for your help and all that as well. Before we go any further, though, let's go ahead and go in a word of prayer as we ask God to bless the time that we have here. Would you join me? Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for bringing us here today. Lord, we ask a blessing over this time, and Lord, we pray as you have let your light shine over these last several days to these young people, Lord, that you would just continue to lead them, that you would continue to let your light shine here in this service today. Lord, we pray a blessing over all who have gathered here. We pray a blessing over all who are watching online right now. And Lord, we ask a special blessing, Lord, for the Olenek family. Lord, we pray that you would be with them in this difficult time. Lord, you know there are many among us here today who have a multitude of hurts. But Lord, you heal our hurts, and so we thank you for that. So we ask that you would be the healer at this time. Lead us, continue to remind us of your love for us. And we ask these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. So in addition to the pledges and things, after we would do this, we would leave from here, and we would go to one of four different stations. We had snack time, which was a big hit. Everyone loves snacks, right? You really can't go wrong there, right? Did you like snacks? Yeah. And then we had crafts. They got to make all kinds of really cool stuff. And then we had our outdoor recreation. It's outside playtime. We realize that recreation is such a really, really big word for little kids. But outside playtime. And then we had our music time, in which we would learn a multitude of songs that teach the lessons that we were learning each day. And so one of the things we wanted to do is share a couple of those songs with you. So I'm going to invite Lieutenant Caitlin to come forward. And she is going to invite the kids up, and she's going to lead them in showing you some of these songs. So take it away. Historically, this is always part of the choreography.
Thank you. There's a spot for each new day. Wherever he will lead me, I'm gonna follow Jesus all the way.
Jesus.
All right, kids, you can go find your grown-ups. Well, as our young people make their way to their grown-ups, I wanted to take a moment and just share a little bit about how phenomenal this year was. So I was just giving some numbers. We had, on average, about 42 kids each and every day of VBS. That is unheard of. We haven't seen that in years. I think that is absolutely phenomenal. Yeah. And that happens because of a couple things. One, you know, because we have fantastic young people. We've also got some pretty cool grown-ups, too. So, grown-ups, thank you so much for bringing these young people to come and hear about the love of Christ. It happens because of you, right? We're taking an interest in their lives and setting them up so that they know that God loves them. And we also have a fantastic group of volunteers. If you had something to do with VBS, we had some that volunteered throughout the week, some that helped before everything happened. If you had anything to do with VBS, if you would, please stand. Let's give you a round of applause here. Thank you so much for all your hard work. Yeah, this doesn't happen without volunteers just like you. And again, grown-ups, you know, those volunteering, those who brought your children, again, thank you for being part of this team to help show this love to these children. I want to show you a little bit more about what we did during this week. We'll come back to that in just a second. But one of the things I wanted to do is to give you a little bit of a preview. We told you about the stations that they went to, and we've seen some of the songs firsthand. But you don't get a chance to really see everything else. So we have a little video that we've put together, kind of showcasing all of that. So if you would, please bring your eyes up to the view screen as we put that on. There we go.
Shout out your praise. There's joy in the house of the Lord. Our God is sure. crown with royalty. We were the presence, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise. Cause we were the beggars, now we're royalty. We were the prisoners, now we're running free. We are forgiven, accepted, redeemed by His grace. Let the house of the Lord sing praise.
There's joy in the house.
There is joy in this house.
There's joy in the house of the Lord today. And we won't be quiet.
Fantastic. So many good things. And one of the, so I'm sure you saw, the buckets, the space buckets. You have to remember everything during Space VBS is space something. So as we passed around our space buckets, you saw in the space video, they were putting all the things in for the shoe boxes. Absolutely phenomenal work. There's going to be a lot of little boys and girls just like you that are going to be blessed all around the world because of the work that you've done. And again, thank you to the grown-ups for that. So, as I said before, we're going to kind of walk through a little bit of what we learned this year in VBS, and as our essential verse was, the John 8:12, Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." Would you join me as we pray once more, asking God to bless this time? Heavenly Father, again, we thank you for this wonderful week that we've had. We thank you for being the light. And Lord, we pray at this time that you would help us to understand what that means. Lord, be our light here and now. Help us to see. And Lord, we pray for these young people, Lord, that you would continue to make yourself known in their lives as you have revealed yourself in this last week, revealed your love for them. Lord, we pray that you would continue to use us to show your love. Lord, use us to help them along in this journey, to teach them, and to give you glory the entire way, because you alone are worthy of glory. And we ask all of these things, praying in the way that you have taught us, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those that have sinned against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." Well, each day we had a separate lesson, and so we're going to kind of skim across the surface just a little bit. If you want the details, you're going to have to ask your kids. They will be more than happy to give you the full detailed version of all of our lessons. But I think it's important that we as grown-ups kind of understand the central theme, right? Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." So what did that mean? Obviously, he wasn't made of light. Meant something different. Even though he was God's son, he was made of flesh and blood just like us. And so when he says, "I am the light," that means something completely different. Day one of our lessons talked about the birth of Jesus and how he came to this earth as a child, born in a lowly stable, a dirty stable, with the sounds of animals all over the place. We even had the kids making animal sounds and things, so they understood it wasn't a very pleasant place for a baby to be, but that is the way that Jesus came. This world can be a dark place sometimes. There are times in which we become overwhelmed by the worries and the struggles that we have in the world around us. And sometimes it just doesn't feel like things are getting any better. I don't know if you've experienced that. I know I certainly have. Sometimes you just feel like you're taking, you know, two steps forward and three steps back, and things just don't seem to be getting any better. And just like then, there are a lot of promises that get made that don't always seem to come through. We feel like we have a hard time trusting when promises are true. There are a lot of things told to us that we just don't see happen. And that's what made the birth of Jesus so special, was that it was a promise kept. Because you see, our God is faithful. In a time where there was no faithfulness, in a time where it was so dark and so gloomy, Jesus came. This light, this message of hope to the world, that the promised Savior had come, because our God keeps his promises. And so we see Jesus' light shine into the world through that. And our message is continued on in the next day. We learn the story of Zacchaeus, little old Zacchaeus who had to climb up a tree to see Jesus as he came by. And we talked about how he probably sounded a little something like this, but he may not have. We're not entirely sure. And the verse for that day that our kids had learned comes out of the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 16. It says to live in harmony with one another. See, this hope that had come with God, it changes people. It changes people for the better. And what happens when we have hope is that we start to see the world around us in a completely different way. Seeing things in the light can really help us see things in a different way. Sometimes it helps us to know that maybe we have some more toys in our rooms that we have to clean up. And so we kick them under the bed if we're not being good about that. But it helps to see things in a new light. It helps Zacchaeus to see the world in a new light. You see, when Zacchaeus looked around and saw all the people, Zacchaeus was a tax collector. And he wasn't a very well-liked guy. And every person he saw out there was another person to collect taxes from, another person to defraud. And the people saw him as this little guy that was just out to take their money. They had this image of one another that just wasn't good. But Jesus came by that day, and little Zacchaeus climbed up that tree to get a better look. And as he passed by, he said something to Zacchaeus. What did he say, kids? Do you remember?
I'm going right to your house today.
He said that too. He said, Zacchaeus. He called him by name because he knows us by name. And he says, come down here. I'm going to your house today. And the people around were surprised. They said, what are you doing? Why are you hanging out with this man? Because Jesus saw something different in him. You see, what everyone else saw was this wicked tax collector, but Jesus saw something different. Jesus saw who Zacchaeus could be. And Jesus changed Zacchaeus in that one meeting. They got together, and because of Jesus, because of his light, Zacchaeus began to see the world in a different way. You see, that's what happens when we begin to spend time with the Lord. When we spend time with Jesus, we begin to see one another the way that God sees them. We begin to love one another the way that God loves us. It changes people. It changes Zacchaeus, and it can change you. Spending time with Jesus changes people. It's a good thing that we probably pay attention to that. You know, we tend to spend time thinking about the things that we're going to spend a lot of time with, right? If you're going to, you know, be with your family, right, you pay more attention to the way you treat people if you're going to be around with them a lot longer. Shouldn't always be that way, but that's typically how it goes with us if we're being honest with ourselves. And the reality is the Bible tells us that we're going to spend eternity together. So boys and girls, just so you know, eternity is a very, very long time. Yeah, really, really long time. And if we're going to spend an eternity with one another, I'm talking to you now, grown-ups. You're involved in all this, right? If we're all going to be spending an eternity together, we should probably start treating each other nice now. Get to know one another, because eternity is a long time. And so we be kind to one another because Jesus changes us. Our lessons continue on, and we see Jesus coming into the town, this triumphal entry, as he's entering into the city. And we talked about how he came in on this donkey, and he had to acquire the donkey because, and he said if they were to ask about it, kids, what were they supposed to say if anyone asked about the donkey? The Lord has need of it. There it is. The Lord has need of it. They listen. Like I said, if you want the details, ask them. They'll give you the rundown. And our passage for this day comes out of the book of Psalms. This is Psalm 100. It says, to shout with joy to the Lord, all the earth. And I love how it includes that. All the earth, not just some, not just part of the earth, all the earth. You see, light has a way of changing our moods. And we in Washington, we know this. Right? We know this very well. Right? When we go a long period of time with no light, what happens? We get kind of gloomy, right? We're like, well, it's a good day. You know, it just sort of changes you a little bit. And then the sun comes out, and all of a sudden our moods get better. The light changes things. The light changed people. As Jesus came into the city, there was this joy that filled the crowds, that filled the people. That same joy that came to us as hope on the day of his birth was now coming out of us in praise. That's what happens when we have joy inside of us. It eventually kind of bubbles up and it wells up and it comes out as praise, like a cup that's just running over. And when the people began to praise Jesus, the Pharisees who saw this, they didn't like it. Now, we had some Pharisees as we were doing our lesson. We had the kids, they were cheering, and then we had the Pharisees in the back, and they were going, boo! So, kids, I don't know if you want to show your grown-ups. What does it sound like? So, those in the front here, I'm sorry to those in the back. I'm going to need you to be my Pharisees today if you can. Everyone in the front here, can you give some cheers to Jesus? What's that sound like? Sounds pretty good. Your kids know what it sounds like. Kids? Boo! They do excellent. And when that happened, those in the back were going, boo! Can I hear a boo?
Boo!
Yeah. We've got some really enthusiastic Pharisees. But that's what was happening. And Jesus rebuked them. And he said this. He said, I tell you, if these were silent, he's referring to the people. He said, if these were silent, the very stones would cry out. Because all of God's creation was made to give him glory, to give him praise. And so if we don't do it, the very stones of this earth will cry out to him. And we learned something really cool, because it's a space theme, right? And we're talking about the stars and the galaxies and the planets and all of this. And the scriptures tell us that day and night they send forth speech. They're out there just singing his praises all the time. You look up at the stars at night and all you see is his creation singing him praises, giving him glory. And we even did something pretty cool. We got a chance to listen to one of them because we've taken microphones, really, really big ones, and we've pointed them up at where the stars are. And we've managed to get some signals that we can turn into sounds, and they make really, really cool sounds. And so we can hear the praises of the stars. And we got a chance to listen to those. So the very rocks of the earth, the very stars of the sky will give him praise because that's what happens when we have the light of Christ in us. Our praise is a way of saying thank you to God, and we have so much to be thankful for. Even in the most difficult of times, God is good, and we have so much to be thankful for, and so we give him thanks. If we don't, the rocks will. Our message continued on to take us all the way to the biggest demonstration of love we have ever been given. Jesus on the cross. And our verse for the day came out of John. John 14:1 says, don't let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Now, here in this room, right, if it were to get dark, and it can't because it's, you know, we've got a ton of windows and it's the morning, but if it were to be dark in this room, we could flip a switch and we could drive all the light out, or all the darkness out, rather, with the light. But it wasn't like that. You see, the light that Jesus is referring to, the darkness that the Bible is referring to, it's talking about sin. It's talking about sin. And just like we all experience darkness at some point in time in our lives, we've all sinned. And darkness can't be in the same place as light. Have you ever noticed that? If you ever tried to do that, just kind of like flip the switch back and forth a couple of times and see if you can get them to happen at the same time. They can't. Because when light shows up, the darkness must flee. They can't coexist. And so we in our darkness of sin cannot coexist with Jesus, who is the light. And so to make a way, because Jesus wanted us to be with him, right? Jesus gave us his light. He used his light to push back that darkness, and he did so by giving his life on the cross. He paid the penalty for our sins. He paid our ticket to heaven so that we could be with him. Our message continues on to let us know that that's not the end of it. Because that's wonderful news. And if that was the last thing we had ever heard, that is fantastic news to know that we have a ticket to heaven, that we have a ticket to that eternity with one another that we talked about. That's a very, very long time. An eternity where we're going to be singing God's praises, saying thank you, and just overflowing with joy, right? Joining with the stars and even the rocks in giving him praise forevermore. That alone is wonderful. But we get another message that he's still with us even after that. In the Bible, our story fast forwards a little bit, and we hear about a man named Philip. Jesus sends him to find this Ethiopian. And he's sitting out there, and he's going through some scrolls, and he's having a hard time making sense of it. And Philip finds him, and he says, "Explain this to me. I don't understand this." Now, this was a smart guy, but he didn't understand what was in front of him. And so Jesus sent a helper. And just like Jesus sent Philip to this man, Jesus has given us a helper in the Holy Spirit. You know, sometimes, you know, we can be smart people, but we get stumped by things a lot. Even when the light is showing what is in front of us, right? We can have a hard time finding our way. In fact, sometimes the light even shows us just how lost we are. Sometimes we sort of wander. I don't know if you've ever done this, kind of wandering through the house at night. Sometimes we can wander and we can think we are in one place, and then we turn a light on and we realize, I was going for the kitchen and I'm in the bathroom. How did that happen? We can be very, very lost. But the light shows us where we are. And the Holy Spirit that has been given to us, he leads us. He explains things to us. He helps us to understand the things that we can't understand. Now, the reality is not all things are meant to be understood. Some things are unknowable. And there are some things that are not meant to be known right now. And he gives us peace in those times. He helps us to move forward and continue to follow him. Even when we don't know where we're going, even when we don't know what's happening, we trust in him and we follow where he leads us. Just like we're a kid in the back seat, just looking out the window. All the grown-ups drive. We trust him. We don't know where we're going. We'll figure it out when we get there. But we know the person behind the wheel loves us enough to take us where we need to be. And so we trust God in that way. It's a wonderful, wonderful message. A wonderful story of the light of Christ coming into this world. The light of Christ changing us. The light of Christ saving us. Transforming us into something new. But the scriptures don't end there. You see, where Jesus began saying, I am the light of the world, he goes on to say something here in the book of Matthew that I think is phenomenal. He says this. He says, you are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. You see, that charge has been given to us. We, who carry Christ's light, have been tasked with taking that light out into the world so that others may see. Now, boys and girls, I need you to remind your grown-ups of this one, because we're probably going to leave and we're going to start thinking about what we're doing today. We're going to get back in Monday morning and work's going to start up, and it's easy to forget how important it is for us to be the light. We've got a job to do. It's a dark, dark world. But just like little tiny candles, each and every one of us goes out taking the light of Christ And it's a beautiful, beautiful thing. Let that light shine. As we bring things in for a little bit of a landing, I'm going to close in a word of prayer, and then I'm going to tell you a little bit about another song we put together. Would you join me as we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you for being that light. Lord, we thank you for loving us so much that you sent your Son to take the penalty of our sins, to die in our place, that through you and you alone, we can have salvation. Lord, we thank you for leading us. We thank you for giving us hope. And Lord, we pray that where we now have hope, that we can share that hope with others, that joy that we have, the satisfaction we have in you wouldn't simply stay with us, but Lord, that would overflow and well up in us and come out as praise because you are worthy of praise. Let us join the chorus of the stars and the rocks and the trees and the flowers and every created thing in singing your praises forevermore. And help us to be your light in this dark, dark world. And we ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. So I'm going to invite Lieutenant Caitlin to come forward again. And so this is going to resonate with you grown-ups, because like you, like so many of you, I grew up in a world that had 9 planets. And our children are growing up in a world that does not. It has 8 planets and a dwarf planet that I think is still a planet. Yeah. We're having a debate about that with some of the young people. They're like, no, it's not. Grown-ups, set them straight. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And what that tells us, you know, we see throughout in the scriptures that God loves us no matter how big or how small we are. Right? Remember little Zacchaeus. God loves Zacchaeus. And it didn't matter about your size. You're still worthy of God's love. And it doesn't matter how big you are. You could still be a planet. And so we wrote this little song, kind of reminding us that God still loves us, again, no matter how big or small we are, just like Pluto. So, yeah, let's teach him Pluto. On a clear, clear night, if you look at the sky, there's so many stars above, you couldn't count them if you tried. From a million miles away, they all look the same, but our great God above, he knows them all by name. He made the stars and the planets and the moon and the sun. He put them all in place. Now doesn't that sound fun? But there's a teeny tiny bell that you might not know. He's my itty bitty buddy called Pluto. In our solar system, he's the end of the line. Though he's not still a planet, he's doing just fine. He's so far away, he needs the ladder just to see us. Maybe climb up a tree like little old Zacchaeus. But big or small, one thing I know is God still loves me like Pluto. Yes, God still loves me like Pluto. You got it. On a bright, bright day, if you look at the ground, there's a million creepy crawly things crawling all around. If you don't pay attention, you can miss them all, cause you're so big and they're so small. But our great big God has big eyes to see. He remembers the birds and he remembers me. I may be small right now, but one day I'll grow, but not my little buddy called Pluto. In our solar system, he's the end of the line. Though he's not still a planet, he's doing just fine. He's so far away, he needs a ladder just to see us. Maybe climb up a tree like little old Zacchaeus. But big or small, one thing I know, God still loves me like Pluto. Yes, God still loves me like Pluto. Yeah, a little love for Pluto there. I think he deserves it. So, yeah, it doesn't matter how big or how small we are, we have a God who loves us, and I think that is absolutely phenomenal. We need to be reminded of that each and every time. Would you join me in a word of prayer? As we prepare to go our separate ways here in a little bit. I hope you don't run off too fast. We're going to have some snacks outside or out in the fellowship hall. We would love to get a chance to meet some of you and get a chance to know you a little better. We know you're little ones. We've probably heard all kinds of stuff about like you and everything, and so we need you to set the record straight because kids talk. But no, we have an opportunity as we prepare to go our separate ways to be the light of Christ. And again, I want to remind us of the charge that we've all been given. Right? Jesus said, He is the light of the world, and He came into this world. And then He turns and says, You are the light of the world. Now, we're not Jesus, but we should point people to Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Would you join me as we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank You so much for loving us. We thank You for being the light, and we thank You, Lord, for giving us this responsibility. Lord, we know that You love us no matter what, no matter how big or small we are. Lord, You love us all the same. Continue to remind us each and every day that You're with us. When it feels like we're all alone in this world, we pray that You would just encourage us, fill us with Your joy, remind us of Your presence. And Lord, I pray that if when we don't see You around, Lord, that we would come alongside one another, that we would see You in one another, just as You have given us that light. Help us to love one another. Help us to draw together as a family that You have created. Each and every one of us here, we are one family. We're going to rejoice in heaven. We're going to rejoice here on earth. We love You, Lord. Thank You for loving us. And we ask all of these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. Well, folks, looks like I've got to go save Miss Melinda. So until we meet again, may the Lord bless you and keep you.
Can I go walk on stage?